So how do we represent a class in a class diagram? Class is represented as a rectangle with three parts. The first part is the class name. Classes should be named using the vocabulary of the domain, so we should pick names that make sense. And the normal naming standard requires that classes are singular nouns starting with a capital letter. The second part of the class are the attributes of the class, where the set of attributes for the class define the state for the class. And we can list an attribute simply by name, or we can provide additional information. For example, we might define the type of the attribute, and we might also define an initial value for the attribute. Finally, the third part of the class consists of the operations of the class. And normally, the operations of the class are represented by name, with a list of arguments that the operation will take as input, and with the result type, so the type of the result produced by the operation. Something else you can note in this representation is the fact that there is a minus before these attributes and a plus before this operation. This indicates what is called the visibility of these class members. So the minus indicates that the attributes are private to the class, so only instances of this class, roughly speaking, can access these attributes. And notice that this is what allows to enforce the information hiding principle, because clients of the class cannot see what's inside this box, what are these attributes. The plus, conversely, indicates that this is a public operation, so something that is visible outside the class. And in fact, normally, this is what we use to define the interface for my class. So we encapsulate the state of the class and we make it accessible to the extent that we want and that is needed through a set of public operations. Last thing I want to note is the use of these ellipses that we can utilize if we want to indicate that there are more attributes, for example, or more operations, but we just don't want to list them now. Okay, now that we know what a class is and how is this represented, let's start our analysis of our course management system by identifying the relevant classes in the system. We need to bring back the description of our system, and what we want to do is that we want to go through the description and underline the relevant nouns in the description. And here, I encourage you to stop the video and to do the exercise of underlining such nouns yourself before listening to my explanation and to how I do it. For example, in this case, I might want to underline the registration manager, which is a noun and probably a relevant one. The scheduling algorithm also seems like a relevant concept. So is the course offerings, again, course offering over here, definitely the students seem to be a relevant noun, and so is probably the registration form and the professors. Okay, so at this point, I identified 7 possible classes for my system. So what I'm going to do is simply to create classes for each one of these nouns. So my initial class diagram looks exactly like this, with the 7 classes, where for each class, I pick the name that is representative of the domain. So in this case, it's pretty straightforward. The registration form is called registration form. The student is called student, and so on and so forth. But you can already see how this analysis method is starting from a description of the real world, and it's just identifying objects or classes in the real world and transforming them into entities in my analysis document.